Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how you can dramatically improve your brainstorming workflow in any AI tool. I will show you how you can bring a visual way of thinking using knowledge graph, where you represent the text as a network of concepts and topics, and how you can find the gaps in your thinking using this representation, and then bridge these gaps or ask the AI to bridge these gaps to generate new ideas for you. And we will do all that inside Claude using the MCP server that I created in Frenotus. But you can also create your own MCP server, and I will show you how you can do that exactly for the same task. So what you will do here is that you will take some piece of content. For instance, in this case, I have this website that I created, which is a landing page for heart rate variability measuring tool, but it could also be your own text or scientific research that you would like to improve. And what we're going to do is that we will represent it inside Claude as a network, find the gaps inside that you can see right now on the screen, and then ask the built-in AI inside Claude to generate some interesting ideas for us based on this representation. And on top of that, we will also ask this MCP server from Infernodus to see what people actually find when they search for this stuff and what kind of content they're interested in. So we will also adjust it to the market. So we'll explore the whole process from analyzing the page and finding gaps inside to actually seeing how you can improve it so that it fits better the expectations of your audience. So if you're interested, keep watching and I will demonstrate how it works. So first of all, what are the tools that we'll be using? We'll be using Claude. In this case, I have the Claude desktop version, but you can also use the web version. And inside Claude, you have this option to connect additional tools and MCP servers. And if you don't know what an MCP server is, I have another video on this topic that I will link to above. But basically, it's a collection of tools that tells the model what kind of approaches it can use in order to solve some of the problems that you might have. And then every time you use this chat, for example here, it's going to have access to the collection of the tools with the descriptions, and it will be able to use this additional workflows in order to get the results that you need. Let me show you how it works. So for example, let's say I have this webpage, somasync.app, which is a landing page of the app that I developed. And I would just like to see if I can improve it in any way. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to Claude, and then I will say extract the content of this page and tell me what I'm missing. Right? So the interesting thing here is that I'm kind of asking it to extract the content of the page first and then to use its own intelligence to tell me what I'm missing in this text. So here it's not yet using any tools, it's just using the standard Claude version. And you will see that it's talking about the app that I'm presenting on that website, haptic biofeedback app for iPhone and Apple Watch. And then it's talking about all the different features it has and then how to use it. So basically it didn't really do the job that I asked, because I asked it to tell me what is missing. And this is where the tools can become very useful, because if you have those additional tools available, then you can start asking the system to generate some really interesting insights based on those tools. So for instance, here I can tell it, okay, tell me what are the main topics inside. And because I have this tool in Frenotus attached to it here, and it has a tool that generates topical clusters, Claude automatically understands that it can actually use this tool to generate the response that I need. So it will generate the request. You see, it's taking the content of the whole website, and then it's going to send that request to the Infernode server and then give me a much better overview, which is much more structured, because this particular tool specifically analyzes the content of the page. And let me show you what it's doing under the hood. So basically it represents the whole text as a network where every concept is a node and every occurrence is a connection. And then it builds topical clusters. And so basically it creates a representation of text network and how the different concepts are connected. And this is a very nice way to know what are the main topics and also how much influence they have in the main discourse. And then of course, we can also use that to identify what's missing. So for example, I can ask it now to tell me, okay, tell me what are the gaps inside. And look what's gonna happen. It's going to request another tool inside the Infernodus MCP server, which is called generate content gaps. So it identified from the prompt what I actually need, what tool it needs to use, and then it generates the content of the page here again and makes a request to that tool. And what happens under the hood, I'm going to show you, it basically takes this whole representation, identifies the structural gaps inside, looks at them, and generates some interesting ideas and research questions that would bridge those gaps. So it's basically things I'm talking about, but I'm not yet connecting. And this can be very interesting in any scientific research, or if you're writing a text, or even if you have a landing page like me and you want to address certain needs, but maybe some of the things that you wrote about are not well connected. So this tool actually helps you do exactly that. So for instance, here it's telling me, okay, you're talking about heartbeat system and recovery metrics, but you're not connecting them together. So that could be an interesting piece of content to create, right? So here it's explaining me how I could do that. Or I could connect recovery metrics to dynamic connection. And then you have fractal variability in heartbeat system. So I'm not explaining this link so much. So then it gives me, see, like all these ideas that I could use to kind of develop this content further. And I can then, of course, ask Claude to give me some ideas on how I can improve the page based on this feedback, right? So then it's just going to give me some ideas for what I could add into the text or what I could add into the website. But also you see, like, because I asked it to generate some ideas, it actually has access to the tool, generate ideas from it for another. So now it's going to take those gaps and then it's going to use the built-in AI to generate these ideas from this text. So here it's telling me specifically, add the science behind the metrics section, which I don't have on that page, or create adaptive training loops section. So it's somewhere where I'm telling people how they can use this data to actually train. So this gives me really good insights on how I can improve the landing page and make this more understandable, or how entrainment works. So explaining how this approach can work and so on. So you see, like, it's giving me ideas, but it's giving me those ideas based on a very structured approach. And unlike the very first answer I got, which was quite generic and didn't even address my request, right? Like here, because I have tools that specifically respond to this kind of questions, it generates much more precise responses. And then I can get some insights from them. And I also know how it's working underneath. So that's also very important. It's not making things up. It's based on a very specific algorithm that scans through these gaps in your discourse. That's what it's doing under the hood. And then it feeds the model with these additional structural insights about the knowledge graph that represents this text. And then you see, then we can generate some interesting ideas based on that. And what I also like, that once you have this generated, you can ask the system, okay, tell me, what do people usually search for in relation to these topics? And look what's going to happen. Because Claude has access to the special tool inside Infranodus, which is analyzing search intent, right? So here it's going to ask that tool. So you see, like, it actually asked the wrong tool first. So this is very interesting, because when it makes a mistake, it receives an error and then it can fix its own error. So here it received another mistake because I think it gave it too many requests. And now finally, it generated the correct request with the correct number of search queries that would relate to the stuff that people would type on Google to find this content, right? HRV training, heart rate variability, biofeedback apps, and so on. So now we first analyze the gaps in the content. And now we're looking for what people actually might be searching for in relation to this content, right? So we found some stuff that we already knew. For instance, heart rate variability is searched actually quite a lot. And then Apple Watch HRV. So this is good because it means that we're addressing a market. But for example, here, vagus nerve exercises, we don't actually have that so much on that page yet. Or practical implementation questions, right? So here it's telling us, okay, you could actually add all those stuff. And there are also medium volume search patterns that you could add to that page to attract that audience. So it also gives me an idea on how I can expand this discourse. If it's a web page, how I can address the different other needs that people who are interested in this stuff might have. But also, if I'm writing research, it's very interesting because it's giving me, like, a much wider picture of what's going on and how I can improve it. And then once I have this insight, I can just ask Claude, okay, so how I could integrate those ideas into this landing page, right? So I can just interact with it in a normal chat form. Now it has in its context all of those ideas that it generated using the Infranodus tool to see what actually people search for when they search for the stuff, right? And then, so what happened now was that it actually used another tool that I have available here called polysingularity thinking tools, which is a mix of sequential thinking protocol and also using some of the logic that I augmented it with. I'm going to also link this MCP server in the description to the video. That's actually free to use. It's based on the existing one, but adding some interesting extra functionality, right? But what happens here is that, okay, it analyzed sequentially all these results that it has, and then it's telling me, okay, how you could actually improve that page. So for example, it says, okay, in the hero section, you can talk to the pain points first. So I have to talk about reducing anxiety and building nervous system resilience, right? Then it says, okay, you could also explain how the metrics that you propose actually works in a very clear way. And then I could also create a benefits section. So you see, this other server that I have added here, it took the content that we generated with the knowledge graph and then generated a very structured outline of the insights and very concrete improvements that I can add onto this web page or text. So this is really amazing because it's like using different agents together in order to help them think about your particular problem. And on top of that, what you can also do is to say, like, okay, so take the original page text and develop it further. And when you do that, it's going to use another tool that it has access to, which is inside Infranodus, which is called develop a text tool, right? So basically it's going to, again, generate some kind of like representation of the text that it's analyzing. And you can also watch how it's generating it here. Sometimes it takes a little moment because it's quite slow, 4.5. Okay, so now that it used this tool, it actually received quite a lot of information about the different stuff that you can improve based on this content. And this tool, it actually uses a combination of structural gaps analysis that I showed you before, but what it also does is that it identifies the conceptual gateway. So these are the keywords that you can use to connect this discourse to other topics. And one last thing that it does is that it identifies the topics that are underrepresented here. So for example, here you see I'm talking about natural patterns and feedback timing, and they're not so big. They only have 7% and 7% of influence. And then it tries to see how it could develop them further. So it's taking the things that are missing or that exist in the discourse, but that are underdeveloped. And then it kind of combines the insights based on all of those ideas to give you the final result. So here, as you can see, it almost rewrote the whole landing page for me, the whole text. And I can use it as inspiration to then change the real landing page or even create maybe an article on this topic. But now it's going to include all these different topics and gaps that are missing, while also integrating the insights about the search patterns that people have. So it's really a perfect mix because it's already based on what I know, what I was thinking about, what I'm interested in, right? But then it's also taking into account the new ideas that I could generate based on my knowledge, based on the gaps that we identified. And on top of that, it's adding the search intent of people. So what they're searching for, how I can integrate their existing demand into whatever it is that interests me and make that page, that landing page or that research paper I'm writing appeal to a wider audience. So I find this workflow is very, very useful. I'm implementing it now in everything I do, and it's really great because it's just good for inspiration. You can brainstorm really well with it. It's very quick, it's very efficient, and it's also not just based on some stuff that AI makes up, but actually it's based on a concrete approach that you can verify visually inside Infernodus because you understand how that works, right? So you understand what's happening under the hood, and it's never something hallucinated, but it makes a lot of sense also. So that's what I really like. I hope that you try it out. Let me know what you think about it. Also, if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments to the video below, and also please subscribe to this channel so that this video can get recommended to other people interested in the same content. Thank you very much.